This is a tutorial on how to use my Jack Daniel's inspired beer mug etch template. This is the first tutorial I've ever recorded, so please do not mind the watermark there. Also, bear with me as I make mistakes. I've also only been using my Cricut for about 2 months, so I'll probably be clicking the wrong thing every now and then. So let's get started. I did make this all on my own. I took an image of a Jack Daniel's logo and I believe I contoured some things out of it. So if you can see, let's take away what I didn't use. So really what I kept was the number and all the little squiggly lines and the distilled and bottled by. However, I did make that a little bit bigger. The fonts that I used are Jasper Daniels for the name, Courier for the bottom two lines, and then I believe the man was Lynchburg script. The myth was Menlo. That one's probably wrong. I'm not 100%. And the legend is Motlow Caps. Please, if you are selling these, go and buy the fonts. You don't want to take from people that are just trying to make a living off of making fonts. Anyways, let's jump into actual work. So the name is actually three separate parts, as you can see here. The capital letters are separate from the rest because they're different sizes. So the name that we're going to put here is actually Brian Hughes. So let's change that. Why aren't you working? This happens quite often with me, so please bear with me. Oh, we got to ungroup it, that's why. I like to use a period to keep a space for the front letter. You can either weld or slice this out. It depends on what letter you're using and what you want to do. I try to avoid slicing just because it's a few extra steps. Oops, make sure you're in lowercase letters for this. Space for the H. I'm not sure if you can hear my sister, but fun fact, you can reuse the Hollister bags if you need to ship them. Alrighty. So with the name, you want to make sure that the bottom of the first letter is in line with the bottom of the last letter. So here it is not. There's a couple different ways you can do this. You can use the curve, or you can just rotate it. We're just going to rotate it. And then just play around with it. A lot of this is just trial and error until you find what you want. That looks good. We're going to rotate this one. And we're actually going to make this one just a little bit smaller to fit in between the N and the U. Alright, that looks good. We're going to group them all together. I advise not to weld until the very end because you might find things later on that you don't like. Like earlier, I didn't like how long this part was. And I keep going back and forth with how the names look. So yeah, we're going to group that. We're going to bring it down slightly. I also like to make the name wider than the like squiggly part. I think that's how it is in the actual logo. I'm not 100% sure. It's been a minute. And then center horizontally. If you're new like me, I always hit the wrong thing. Center vertically and center. You don't want to use those ones right now. Make sure it's the horizontally one. For the distillery, this little Hawaiian was a nickname. Most people have been using families, so this is going to be in all caps. Use family. I'm going to make it slightly bigger because last time I made it slightly smaller. Just to make sure it's easier to weed. And instead of Paris, California, it's actually going to be... I'm not 100% sure how Washington is supposed to be abbreviated here, so I'm just going to do WASH. And I actually want to make this just a little bit bigger. Again, this is all mostly preference. Center horizontally. I want to make this go up just slightly. Alright, so there's that. If you did want to change things, like, for instance, when I change the distilled and bottled by, I do a shape. And let's just redo the distilled and bottled by part again. We'll size it up. Slice them. And then you can take out the piece that you want to change. Say you want it that big and put it there. We're not actually going to do that, so that was just an example. When you're slicing, you can only slice two things at a time. So if your result is not working, or if you're not getting the little slice option, know that you probably have too many layers on. I'll weld that back together. I like to work all on the same page. As you can see, I've made several different designs. This one was my first one, and throughout it, I found different things to do. Like, I do not like how the spaces are there. I've already made it, though, so oops, too late. And also, other ones have had, like, different locations and distillery names. But anyways, so I like to group all that together. And then I'll duplicate it so that my next one, I can just use this piece as the template. And then I'll hide that. So we're going to move this just there. And so in order to make what you're etching, if you're just making like the decal, you can use this as is. However, since we're etching, we're going to slice it. Actually show you it this way so you can see what I'm doing. Right, sorry, center. So you want to make it bigger just because this is what you're putting on your glass. So when you're putting the etching cream, you'll probably put like painter's tape on the edge of it to make sure you don't get it outside of the stencil. And then what we're gonna do, I forgot. In order to slice it, like I was saying, you need only two layers. So now is the time to weld all of this together since you've already duplicated it. If you're new, remember, once you weld, the only way to undo the weld is to go back steps. So make sure when you weld, you're doing, like, you know that you don't want to change anything. Slice it. And then get rid of the parts you no longer need. And there's the template. Now a little advice on when you are weeding it. I like to get rid of all the big pieces first. So I'd get rid of the R, Y, N, H, U, H, and S from the top parts. The reason I don't do the other letters is because the other letters have smaller details in them. I found that if you're weeding skills are not great, then there's chances that you're going to be lifting up these smaller pieces, and when you transfer it onto your mug and you put the cream on it, it's not going to adhere in the right place, adhere well, or stay adhered. Same thing with all the other little pieces. I like to do the reverse weeding, so once I get the bigger pieces off, I'll put my transfer tape on top, peel the entire thing off, and then put it onto the mug directly. And then from there, I just peel all the intricate like squigglies and letters off. That way, again, all the small pieces are exactly where you want them to be. Heads up, the distilled and bottled by part, I leave all the little, or I almost take every single one of the little pieces off with it because they are so tiny. And it doesn't make that big of a difference. These are really hard to like perfect. It all depends on how much time and effort you want to put on into them. But yeah, so there's that. And I am so sorry. I just remembered that there is a watermark. So hopefully you guys were able to see everything, because I know I probably didn't do very well at keeping it to the side. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me. Also, please follow and like my business page, Creative Designs by EBC, on Facebook. After this whole COVID incident, I ended up losing my job and having to move back in with my family early. I wasn't planning on doing that until after graduation, after I had a job, and I have neither of those right now. All right, happy crafting, guys.